Greetings. This is the Ghetto Free Press. Today is February the 9th, 2016. I was called here in Thomas County, and I just got out of the courtroom, municipal, wherein the elected mayor of Meigs, Georgia, Linda Harris, was just put on a $10,000 bond for misusing a credit card that belongs to the city of Meigs, Georgia. Now, you all know that I have covered approximately 16 cities where black mayors in Georgia seem to be under attack. This is not a figment of my imagination. I only ask you to Google Boston GBR. If Mayor Linda Harris used a credit card without authorization, and if it is against the law, then she should fall into that law as far as punishment. However, first of all, people need to acknowledge, I have been informed that this mayor, number one, does not even receive a salary. We know that as a result of her being the mayor, she has lost jobs, she has endured pain and suffering, and therefore, I believe, in my most humble opinion, being a novice at this, when it comes down to Georgia labor laws, it seems to me that there should be or could be a law that forbids people from working the equivalent to slave labor. If she does not get paid, then that is kind of like the city of Meigs using a human being to perform services for which they are not paid. Now, if Linda Harris have not received any pay whatsoever since she took office as mayor, look at the hundreds and thousands of dollars that somebody had to post for her bond, and personally, I'm getting tired of it. I see this from Quitman, Georgia. I see this in Meigs, Georgia. I see this in Lumpkin, Georgia. I see this in Dawson, Georgia. I see this in Davisboro, Georgia. I see this in many cities across the state. And my question is, they are going to fill the newspapers up about her violating the law. But the question is, and I hope that somebody in the mainstream media here in the state of Georgia will ask a question. That question should be, how did Linda Harris benefit from what she purchased on a credit card belonging to the city, I'm sure? Then how did she benefit? I understand that she used it so there will be a Christmas party in Meigs for the people that live there, and I'm sure for the little children for Christmas. And as you know, many cities have Christmas parties. Now, if she had not done it, who would have done it? And if they had done it, she would not have had to do it. And we see the same thing in Gordon, Georgia. In Gordon, Georgia, there's much is happening to discredit Mayor Mary Ann Whipple-Lew. This is a pattern and this is a practice. Nobody will report what I'm saying, but I'm telling you, this is my observation based on facts of what is happening in these little towns. This mayor have had to get a lawyer. The city didn't pay for her lawyer. In fact, the lawyer for the city are working against her, according to what they say and according to what I have recorded on video. So I came to Thomas County to sit in the courtroom to see what was going on, because I want you to know the rest of the story. I don't want you to just listen to the Thomasville Times Enterprise and then get what somebody may be biased in, or watch the TV stations who will snip it and bite it. I want to show you in a few minutes the complete ordeal took place in the courtroom, which is not much. But then again, you decide. And then I want you to go to the videos and let these real world videos be your witness. Let it be your deciding factor if you think there's an asserted effort to circumvent the power of the black vote and black from holding positions of power in the state of Georgia. I ask you to Google the Quitman 10 plus 2 that was put on under, was charged and for what charge of 119 violations, only to have all of them dropped after 4 years. And it is indeed something that the American people need to look at, and you need to understand that we had to fight just to get a right to go to the bathroom. We had to fight to get a right to drink water at a water fountain. We had to fight to get a right to go fight in the armed force on an equal basis to whites. This is not me. Now, I'm criticized for telling you the truth, but all you have to do is check the archival record, and truth speaks for itself. Personally, I have known Linda Hyde approximately 2 years. I don't see any criminal behavior in this individual, but I do believe that they want to keep the old power structure the same. Don't get me wrong. Now, when I say the power structure, I'm not just talking about just white folks. I'm saying they want to keep either white people or black folk who, well, some people have a name for, which I won't mention here. But I'm saying to you that in the end, I am 100% certain that in the end, truth, right, and justice will win in Meigs, Georgia. We'll win in Quitman, Georgia. We'll win in Dawson, Georgia. We'll win in Lumpkin, Georgia. We'll win in Warrenton, Georgia. We'll win in Gordon, Georgia. We'll win in Hancock County. We'll win in Homerville with the voting rights problem there. We'll win in Waycross, Georgia. We'll win in Blackshear, Georgia. All these places, all of them, without exception, seems to be bringing blacks up on charges. And I'm not speaking what I don't know about. I'm asking you, look at the video and go to some of these meetings and see what is going on across the state of Georgia. And even the sad point about it is that Eric Holder, former Attorney General from the U.S. Department of Justice, he knew about this because Representative Tyrone Green sent this to him, much of this information, with the Quitman 10 plus 2. Ms. Lula Smart had a 19-day court case, the only one of the Quitman 10 that went to trial. Her first trial was a mistrial. Her second trial was a mistrial. Her third trial, they dropped all 30-some charges on her, and then the state dropped the other 119 on all of them. But yet, those people's lives have put on hold, and then the state of Georgia say, we just playing a game, there's nothing to it. Now that is a disgrace on our government. And I'm gonna say it again, we had better wake up and understand that Jim Crow is at your back door, and it's time for you to get up and to the realities of what's going on with all these elected black mayors and other black elected officials. Go to Douglas, Georgia. I didn't mention Douglas, Georgia. The commissioner in Douglas, Georgia. Look and see what the Douglas Enterprise, see what they did to her. And I guess the worst is yet to come. But in the end, truth, right, and justice will win beyond question. And if truth, justice, and right does not win, then God himself is a liar. This is the Ghetto Free Press. Bye-bye. Go.
sure that each of you is aware of what it is you've been charged with, and then see about setting bond, if that seems to be the appropriate thing to do. See now, are you Mr. Craig?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then you're Mr. Godfrey?
Yes.
Okay. And you're Ms. Harris?
Yes.
Okay. All right, I want to start out by making sure that you understand a couple of things. The first is that I'm not going to be asking y'all anything about the facts of any of these cases. Number one, we're not at a point where we're trying to adjudicate these cases. Also, you don't have an attorney with you, so I don't want you saying anything that can be used against you later on. So like I say, I'm not going to ask, and I hope you won't start trying to tell me anything that could be used against you later on. Because you just have a constitutional right not to testify against yourself. Also, as I've mentioned, you don't have attorneys with you, but you do have the right to an attorney in these proceedings, you know, from here through the end of the charge. If you can afford one, we certainly would encourage you to get one. If you can't, however, be sure and let the folks back there in the jail know, and one can be appointed for you at no cost to you. And finally, you have the right to a trial by jury on any criminal matter. Doesn't really matter what it is, it's just entirely, and that is your absolute default right under the Constitution. Now, you could, you know, work out a plea, you could have a trial by a judge alone. Yeah, I mean, there are all kinds of ways of dealing with this, and they're all your choice entirely. You're guaranteed the right to a trial by jury if that's what you want. So just keep that in mind. Okay? Mr. Craig, I have here a warrant charging you with forgery in the third degree. Christopher Leon Craig did violate Official Code of Georgia annotated section 16-9-1D when he willingly and knowingly made, altered, possessed, uttered, or delivered a check, checks written in the amount of $1,500 or more in a fictitious name or in such manner that the check as made or altered purports to have been made by another person at another time with different provisions or by the authority of one who did not give such authority. Said act to take place in Thomas County, Georgia on the 25th day of June 2015 between the hours of 12 a.m. and 11:59 p.m. at 15189 U.S. 19 South, Rose City Liquors in Charlottesville, Georgia. Now, that, unfortunately, it's a felony, has a possibility of a 1 to 5 year prison term. What's that?
It was a scam. It was a scam check for prison. I didn't
know. I don't know. You don't need to say anything about it. Because as I say, if you were to say something that was against your interests,
yes,
I actually could be subpoenaed to testify against you.
Yes,
and I really don't want to do that. You know, I don't want you to get yourself into trouble. So, but now, you know, when you get to talk to your lawyer, be sure to tell your lawyer all the circumstances so that they'll be able to help you, you know, maybe come to a better understanding of this, or help the authorities come to a better understanding, or whatever. Just, but I'm not in a position where I want you to say anything against your interests. Okay. So as charged. It would have as much as a 1 to 5 year possible prison term attached to it. Yeah, this shows an address in Valdosta. You live in Valdosta? Okay. Did you grow up over there?
Okay.
So you got family there?
Oh,
okay. All right. Well, And you're 30 years old, is that correct? Single, you don't, do you have any children?
One, I'm a whole.
Oh, back there? Oh, okay, all right. Do you live with them? How long have you been together? Are you working any place right now?
Yes, sir.
Where you work?
I live in a car until shop.
Okay, how long have you been there?
Since October.
Okay.
I don't need it.
It's work?
It's work, I'm basically good.
Are you on any kind of probation or anything like that? Parole? Not on a bond for anything else right now? Usually when I see one of this thick, I think it's bad, but they print it in real big type, so. Not as bad as it actually looks. I'm gonna set the bond in at $2,000 and hope you, everything goes well for you. Okay. Show that today, February 9th, 2016, at 612 Pine Street here in Thomasville, Jimmy Godfrey did attempt to commit a violent injury to the person of Denise Williams by pushing her. Said act to take place in Thomasville, Georgia, and placed her in reasonable apprehension of immediately receiving a violent injury. Mr. Godfrey was highly intoxicated at the time this incident took place. And then, charge of cruelty to children of the third degree, also at 612 Pine Street, also February 9th, 2016, today. Jimmy Godfrey did commit the offense of cruelty to children when he committed simple assault, family violence, in the presence of a Carrie Ann Williams, a child under the age of 18 years. The child was 4 years of age. Now, both those are misdemeanors, which means that they carry a maximum possible penalty of up to 12 months back in the jail, as well as the possibility of up to $1,000 fine. So you understand that? All right. The criminal history they've given me goes back to 1983, and I don't see that it shows much of anything on it other than
I haven't been much.
I was going to say it. There certainly haven't been any felonies. There are some little misdemeanors here and there, and that sort of thing, so that speaks well.
I'm trying to
Everything is over.
Good.
I got law enforcement this morning, actually.
Okay. Well, don't say anything about it, because I don't want you to be in trouble. Are you from Thomasville originally?
No, I'm actually from Berlin.
Berlin?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where do you have family?
Right off the equipment, all over.
Okay.
I've got 10 kids and they're scattered around.
Oh, okay. Are you working anyplace?
Yes, sir. I work at RTD Construction.
Okay. How long have you been there?
Been there since November. Before that, I was with the electric plant. Then after that, before that, I was with our 22.5 years.
Oh, really? Did you retire from there?
Actually, I didn't. I just left there because of the situation that was going on out there, and I just moved on.
Okay. Yeah, I heard.
Yeah.
Things about there.
I see, yeah.
Yeah. All right.
I apologize for what happened this morning. It's out of my control, so.
Okay. Well, like I said, don't get into it, please.
I know.
I just don't want to get you in trouble. What I'm going to do is set the bond, I'm going to set the bond on both of them together at $500. I think I'm going to set the bond on the simple assault at $500, and I'm just going to release you on your own recognizance with regard to the cruelty to children. But the only thing about it is that until this can be resolved in court, get it completely taken care of, I'm going to require that you stay away from Ms. Williams.
Well, she's probably moving out anyway, so that should be no problem.
Okay.
I was hoping that would really happen, but again, they're here this morning.
Okay. Well, where I'm kind of going with that is that in order to make sure that y'all don't get into any kind of arguments or anything like that, I want to just make sure that you stay away from her.
Yes.
If you have to have contact with her, you can call the sheriff's department or the police department.
I don't need no contact.
And set up a time for them to go with you. The reason I say that is that you could be charged with aggravated stalking if you were to violate this condition that I put on here. And that is a felony. It's got a 1 to 5 year possible prison term. So I really don't want you to mess up what looks like a pretty good record here.
I don't plan on.
Okay. I'm sorry, were any of y'all here with Mr. Johnson?
I don't think so.
Okay. Good luck to you. Warrants here, three of them for financial transaction card fraud, and one of them charging violation of public office. The first one of the financial transaction card fraud charges says that said Linda Easton Harris did violate official code of Georgia annotated section 16-9-33 when she willingly and knowingly did commit the offense of financial transaction card fraud by representing without consent of the card holder that she is the holder of specified card, to wit, a Visa card number ending in 0167, and to discharge the amount of $93.90 and deliver said card to Dollar Tree, all with the intent to defraud Dollar Tree and the City of Meigs. Said act to take place in Thomas County, Georgia on the 24th day of December 2015 at 15298 U.S. Highway 19 South, Dollar Tree, in Thomasville, Georgia. And the second one, said Linda Easton Harris did violate official code of Georgia and case section 16-9-3 when she willingly and knowingly did commit defense, financial transaction, card fraud by representing without the consent of the cardholder that she is the holder of a specified card, to wit, Visa card ending in 0167, and did charge the amount of $8.01 and delivered said card to Susie Q Foods, all with the intent to defraud Susie Q Foods and the City of Meigs. Said act to take place in Thomas County, Georgia on the 24th day of December 2015 at 4616 County Line Road, Susie Q Foods, in Thomasville, Georgia. Third one, said Linda Easton Harris did violate official code of Georgia annotated section 16-9-33 when she willingly and knowingly did commit the offense of financial transaction card fraud by representing without consent of the cardholder that she is the holder of a specified card, to wit, Visa card ending in 0167, and did charge the amount of $45.19 and delivered said card to Flowers Bakery Thrift Store, all with the intent of defrauding Flowers Bakery Thrift Store and the City of Meigs. Said act to take place in Thomas County, Georgia on the 24th day of December 2015 at 236 South Madison Street, Flowers Bakery Thrift Store in Thomasville, Georgia. And finally, the violation of oath of public office. That said Linda Easton Harris did violate official code of Georgia annotated section 16-10-1 when she willingly and knowingly did intentionally commit the offense of violation of oath of office as prescribed by law by unlawfully using the City of Meigs credit card without lawful authority. Said act did take place in Thomas County, Georgia on the 24th day of December 2015 in Meigs, Georgia. The card fraud charges are all felonies.
went to, I graduated Thomas Technical Institute, and I went 18 months to the Court Institute School of Massage Therapy, and I drove the buses for the Commons County Schools and worked with them off and on up until I became mayor. I resigned from the bus to be a full-time mayor.
Okay.
Because I worked at SBZ as well. That's the job that I lost because I got arrested the first time.
Okay. So now I guess at this point there are some undisposed of cases from last year, is that correct?
Yes,
things that haven't been finished up yet?
Yes, sir. It's, I guess they're saying they still investigate. I'm not sure.
Okay.
I'm not sure if any of those.
I mean, you haven't been to court and had a final disposition of any of
these.
Are y'all here with Mayor Harris?
Yes.
Do either of y'all want to say anything on her behalf? Or, I mean, you don't have to if you don't, but I'll be happy to hear you.
My whole team is a very practical decision from the city to make the right person.
Okay. Thank you. Did you get it? What I'm going to do then is I'm going to set the bond on the each of the financial transaction card fraud cases at $2,500. That'd be a total of $7,500. And then the violation of the oath of office would be another $5,000. And so we'll work out. Where she went. Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate y'all's coming.
Are you adjourned?
Say your name for me.
George Boston Rhymes.
Spell it for me.
G-E-R-G-E B-O-S-T-O-N-R-H-Y-N-E-S.
Do you live here, Max?
No, I do not.
Thomas County?
Valdosta.
Okay. So you're familiar with the South Georgia area?
Yes.
Would you say that it operates differently than other municipalities?
No, not when it comes down to the mayoral positions. I've covered 16 cities in the state of Georgia, and I find it to be pretty similar to other municipalities.
What would be the best way to sum up what's going on here?
Well, first of all, a lot of people read the newspapers and they watch television, and they believe that Meigs is a little different from other cities. As I said, I've traveled 16 cities. I'm working 16 cities in the state of Georgia. And the charges, the illegal trespass warnings, the arrest of the mayor, Harris' two brothers, they too have received criminal trespass. I've been covering the city for approximately 2 years. And it is no different from some of the other cities. Now, to get to the point of what happened most recently, what I don't understand is why is it that it seems that most of these black mayors in the state of Georgia that I've covered, they are trying to remove them from office. office for a little of nothing, with no reason. Now, from what I read in the paper and what I've seen on television concerning this mayor and the credit card, over a year ago, the state of Georgia, OCR code, which is in this, the charter, the state approved this, and you can call GLA. What they did, they asked this every municipality after January the 1st, they are required to have ordinances as terms of who can use a credit card. I didn't do this. The state knew that there was a problem, so they asked all municipalities to create an ordinance. Now, this was from, I picked up from the city of Valdosta, Georgia, from the city manager over there. And I called other people who are aware of this. But what I don't understand is why is it that the people in Meigs do not understand that this has already been addressed. So if the mayor used those cards in any capacity, and if they do not have a written ordinance, which was a requirement, to my understanding, from the state, why did they do that to her? It seems as if, to me, that there is an assertive effort to remove black mayors from office. I don't care whether it's Quitman, it's Meigs, it's Lumpkin, it's Davisboro, it's Dawson, Georgia, it's Gordon, Georgia is really bad. Warrenton, all these cities have problems where there is newly elected black mayors. Now, I'm not talking about mayors who have been like in Albany. I talked to them too. They don't have the problem, but these newly elected mayors for the last 3 to 4 years, they are having problems. And personally, if you go to my channel, Boston GPR, you can see this. This is a pattern and it's a practice that needs to be addressed. And what I do not understand is why no one are connecting the dots between all of these cities. No one should just look at Meigs. No one should just look at the mayor in Quitman, James Charles Brown III, or in the case of Lumpkin, Charles Brown III. All these cities, Warrenton is George Ivy. In Gordon is Marianne Hoopaloo. In Dawson is Christopher Wright. And there are others. But the point is not meant to Hancock or Sparta in Hancock County. I've done the research. I have addressed it with the Secretary of State. I have addressed it with Georgia Attorney General. I have addressed it with, at every level of government. I have even sent it to Georgia General Assembly. But it seems as if though there is a pattern and there's a practice and nobody really wants to address the issue. Linda Harris, she can't solve this by herself because they are under attack. And it's sad to say that in 2016. I'm a retired military veteran, and I'm really tired of seeing what I see. And my information is well documented. It's over documented. I get comments from Canada, and they're asking what's going on in America.
Now, you know, basically you're saying because there's no ordinance here that she was at liberty to use the credit card for whatever the reason is.
In the purpose from Valdosta, a metro city with 50,000 people.
Right, but they don't have one of those here.
Beg your pardon?
Do they have one of those?
First of all, no, they do not.
So that's the problem in itself.
Right, the problem in itself is right. I was trying to answer your question. Okay. Your question, I was going to read exactly what the ordinance says and what OCR said when they found that there was a problem. This is not Valdosta. This is the state of Georgia.
Right.
And I have been to a meeting with a particular mayor because I have gone to some of the GMA meetings, and this was brought up before. And what I don't, some of these mayors, Lynn Harris may have gone to it, and they had told them they got to have these ordinances, one for the employees and one for the elected officials. And it reads, the deadline is 1 January. It's 1 January of this year.
Okay.
They're supposed to have it in place.
Now, talk to me about, you know, your reaction to seeing the multiple arrests and seeing the way that she's being treated in the community.
To see her arrested, I was there yesterday when she was, you know, bond was set. That's routine for me. Everywhere I go, the same pattern and practice. For instance, Marianne Hoopaloo and Gordon, same thing, they arrested, well, they arrested her. I've been there and recorded her when the sheriff come. They doing everything to remove her from office. And it seems like in these cities, when I see, like yesterday, when I see her, I know, in my opinion, based on the facts and information that I have on video, in most of these cities, it's the city manager it's the attorney for the city, it's a certain group of white Caucasians and blacks that come out against these mayors for certain reasons, but the majority of people in these communities respect these people. They think they are number one citizens, but it's just a certain people. For instance, there are so many cities, and I talked to Georgia Attorney General representative right here in this building, in this room, a few weeks ago. And some cities have not even had a yearly audit in 5 years. Gordon haven't had a forensic audit in 100 years. And there is no one that's overseeing these cities in terms of what is required to account for the taxpayers' money. And so I'm glad that the state of Georgia at least saw a need to come up with some type of guidance, because a lot of cities do not have any procedures on how they should carry out the business of these municipalities. And it's really embarrassing.
What kind of problems do you think it presents not having what you need to operate?
Total chaos, and that's what I see. I see chaos in over in Quitman, I see chaos here, I see chaos in Lumpkin, I see chaos in Dawson, I see chaos wherever I go. And I'm not going to call them all because there's no value in that, but what I'm saying now has already been documented. But the key point that I want to address here is mostly the police department, it's the city attorneys, and it's the city manager, and it's some people on the council who work against the mayor. In fact, in some of these cities, they are changing the type government from a strong mayoral type government to a strong city manager type government. And in most of these cases, all this stuff has been documented, and most of these mayors are aware of it. I even interviewed the mayor of Meigs, Gordon, and another one from Warrenton, Georgia. We met in Macon, and their problems are the same. I just reposted that interview last night, because what's going on with this mayor, when I saw her the other day, I'm sitting there and I'm listening. What they're saying that she, I mean, if she took the money, for instance, the money that they say she took, that list of TV, if she took that money and prepared a Christmas party for the children or parade, that's taxpayers' money going for the children. Check this, in Gordon, Georgia, you wouldn't believe this. Most every municipality have a Christmas party, and most of the Christmas party, the parade, they have a fire truck. The fight and the struggle, the stench is so bad in Gordon until there was no fire truck in the parade, simply because the mayor pro tem would not work with the mayor, and he's over the fire department, didn't even have a fire truck in the parade. And the children, they're accustomed to hearing the fire trucks. And moreover, one more point. The mayor pro tem and Councilman Densley, I'm calling the name because it's an illegal matter now. The mayor, Whipple's attorney, have turned around and filed charges on them for violating the law. They sitting on the council and they turned around and filed charges against the mayor, trying to remove the mayor. You got a tax-exempt organization in Gordon, which is called the Concerned Citizens, and yet they are allegedly campaigning, collecting money to get somebody elected into office. And so that will be in the court of law. But what gets me, my beautiful sister, is the fact that the state of Georgia are fully aware of this, because George bossed around to get off free press. I have presented to every level of government, and in some cases, because it's dealing with voting rights, I have addressed it with former U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder. He has the files on his desk. He should have them. He should have documented videos that Representative Tyrone Brooks and myself sent to him that ties in with the Quitman 10+2 who was charged of 119 violations of voter fraud. And after 4 years, every one of those charges was dropped against those outstanding people. And one, Ms. Luda Smart, she had 30 to 40 voting fraud charges on her. And after a 19-day trial, they dropped all charges. And after they dropped the charges, not one television station, not one newspaper would even report that to the general public. The only person reported was the Get Two Free Press. And that is embarrassing. And so now, George Boston Wright, I'm wondering how deep the mogul hole goes in terms of trying to circumvent the black vote. and keep black from voting. There's an 88-year-old woman in Morgan, Georgia, from all of this. She says she would never, ever vote again. I got that in writing. I'm going to post that on Boston TBR YouTube because the governor needs to know what's going on. And it's time for Georgia or General Assembly to step in and stop putting all these people through all this pain. The pain that this mayor here is going through is no different from Mayor Ann Whipple and what she's going through. And people are getting tired of it. I'm a retired military veteran. I served 21 years. And for me to see all this going on against these black men, I will admit there was two white women too. These are white females that I got information on, and one of them went to court and won their case. So it's much bigger than just the color line. It's just about these small towns. Some of them don't want to change from the good old boy system, and they don't want to count for the money. It's all about the money. It's about, you know, Gordon got 19 bank accounts, and the late finance chair who died, he said, we need to do an account on them because we got too many accounts, but they have fought that forensic audit for over 2 years. From the time Mayor Whipple got in office, they fought it, and they still haven't had a forensic audit. They're talking about what the mayor's getting her for open records violation, they're getting her for violating the Sunshine Law, they get her for taking the keys. When she found out gas was being missing, she wanted to get a clamp on it. But you don't find that in the newspaper. And another thing I want to close by saying this here is that many of the problems in these small towns, they come from the newspaper and the television stations who will not report the truth. And these people, they know what's going on. I have walked the streets here in Meigs. I have family. It's already on YouTube. These people out here, they love Linda Harris. They say she's a Christian woman. And when somebody brings up things, she taking money, they just laugh. And they said, what's going on? And I had all this already documented. She said, none of the other mayors had to go through this. They done banned this woman out of this office. She can't even come up here. The voters elected her to office. Why can't she serve in this office? They did the same thing in May. Gordon. They banned her from the office. The same thing in Lumpkin, Georgia, the city clerk, black lady. You can hear her talking, very educated, overqualified for that position. She's fired today, but she gave her testimony, and I got her on video. All this stuff is real. But what I don't understand is how can the news media, the TV stations, and the newspapers seemingly are a part of the conspiracy. And I believe I fit the word conspiracy because I think I got enough information and have presented to the Secretary of State, to Brian P. Kemp, and to Attorney General Sam Owens, and I wish that CNN Victor Blackwell would call me, because if they call me, I can back up everything that I've said here today, plus so much more. It's documented, sister. I'm serious. This stuff has been documented. I've been at this for 2 years. And I said I'm going to stop.
Well,
and I don't get paid for this.
And, you know, of course, today, I'm more so with the Megs. I do think that it may be something to a bigger picture of what's going on in these areas. But, you know, even yesterday, I know you said you watched it and, you know, feelings about whether or not she did or didn't, and ordinances and what was happening and what isn't happening. You know, we had a police report. I wasn't on the story yesterday. Right, I talked to Ms. Harris shortly after she was arrested. She called. She said, I know you do a fair job and I want you to be the only one.
I heard about you.
You know, and I can appreciate the fact that she took the time to call me, but unfortunately, because I was already on something else and it happened so late in the day, I wasn't able to get up here until today.
Let me say this here now. The mayor in Gordon, she refused to do interviews with all the TV stations. The local newspaper is called the Wilkinson County Post. Judy Bailey was just paid $46,000 for nothing. She asked the police to arrest her, and you can see this on my video. They arrested her. But there's a group of people that they call the Gordon Coalition. That consists of a majority vote on council. They voted her $46,000. The case was never even sent officially to the city. It just was a letter from that lady's attorney, from the editor's attorney, and they paid her $46,000. Never even went to court. If somebody can go in to get that much money from the city government, $46,000, I think for less than 8 minutes, that's a good way to make some money. And the taxpayers had to pay for it. Mm-hmm. One other thing, the news media, as I said earlier, in Gordon, 41, 13, she don't trust any of them. So she really would doubt anybody to report her side. Mm-hmm. So She just stopped doing interviews. The only person she really would let interview is me, because I won't tell the truth, because I have nothing to hide and nothing to gain. I served this country during the Vietnam era, and I served because I thought there was a freedom, some freedoms in this country, like freedom of speech and freedom of the press. But I found out that it seemed like it's about the money and those who control the mass media. There's no restrictions on me, because I believe in this country. I believe in it. And I'm going to stand up for freedom of speech and freedom of the press. It's the flavor of my nature and the nature of my flavor.
You need to.
I'm going to go over, and I told her, her attorney, I'm going to go over the interview. And that's good. But this case, this is what I'm concerned, this is like a, I don't know, I'm going to go to the sheriff's department.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I'm going to the newspapers too. I'm sick of it. I mean, it ain't just this man. See, if it just her, it'd be one thing. But I got the pain of all these other places.
Mm-hmm.
They got rid of all blacks in Hancock County. Go there.
Did you talk to the Thompson man?
They got rid of every one of them. Huh? But the mayor, I ain't talking to him, but
he was just appointed.
Huh?
So he was just appointed.
Well, he was appointed, okay. Mm-hmm. He has no control over this mayor, though, that's the thing about it.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah. But the news media, see, I could say something else about it, but I was with the time of your time.
Yeah.
I know some stuff about that. I'm just going in and let them know that I know what I know.
I've heard some things about you.
But sister, you know, and look, if you can, just be in the long run.
God specializes.